There was a giant python in that room, and it was pitch black. I'm definitely afraid of snakes anyway.
So giving up $100,000.
$486,000 is just fine with me.
Bill, you failed to get the exemption. $50,000 was added to the pot, and tonight there is an execution. Al.
This may be the amongst the toughest 6 weeks I have ever done.
Dorothy and I joined forces, and our plan was to knock out Bruce. Then our plan was to knock out Al, and it worked, and here we are. And now comes the hard part, because now Dorothy and I will be going against each other.
Whatever it ends up looking like, it is all in the spirit of the game. Nothing personal.
Congratulations on making it to the final round. 14 of you started off some 5 weeks ago. We are now down to you, the final three. I know you've all spent a lot of time together, probably more time than you wish. No doubt you've all formed opinions of each other. This next game will test what you think of each other, and more importantly, how well you know what the others think of you. You may remember this game from last year. We call it Three Questions. It's what last year's mole, Catherine, called a hideous game. Now, the three of you have already completed a series of ethical or moral questions about each other. Your ability to predict how your fellow players answered will determine how much money is going to be added to the pot. The first player up is Dorothy. Dorothy, you will be sequestered in a home in this town. If the other two players can correctly predict how you answered three questions, they will be able to find you and add $10,000 to the pot. Dorothy, cat lady, please follow me. I'm going to read you the first question Dorothy was asked. If you think her answer is Bill, go in that direction. If you think her answer is Heather, we'll go in this direction. I know the game appears very simple, but if you miss even one question, you're going in the wrong direction, and you will not find Dorothy and not earn the $10,000 for the pot.
Okay.
First question that Dorothy answered was, who's more likely to vote for themselves in a popularity contest, Heather or Bill?
I think she would say you.
I thought she would say you.
I know for certain because we've had several conversations about self-confidence and how you think you appear to others.
That's fine.
So your answer is Bill?
Yeah.
All right, we'll go in this direction. Who's more likely to stalk an ex-significant other? Do you think she answered Heather or do you think she answered Bill?
You've talked about a number of boyfriends and relationships. I have not ever detected animosity.
No.
Or...
Although you've been married for 31 years, so why would you bother?
I was married once before, got divorced, and I'll never get divorced again.
You see, you think she would say you?
I would say me between those two, and I don't know what she would say. For the life of me, I could not conceive of Heather stalking a past significant other. I just couldn't.
Okay, I agree with you. Yeah. I say Bill.
Okay, you say your answer is Bill. We'll go this way. Okay, final question. Dorothy was asked, who is more likely to lie to a loved one, Heather or Bill?
Well, that's a tough one.
I would say me, just because you've been married for so long. And if you were to lie to your wife, she would know right away.
She would know it instantly. The only other thing I'm thinking about is that we were talking about who can be more deceitful, women or men.
Yeah.
And Dorothy chose women.
Yeah. I would say me.
Mighty quick to say you'd lie to a loved one.
Doesn't mean I would. It just means what I think she would say.
To figure out what Dorothy would say.
Well said, Bill. All right. Your answer is Heather, so why don't you go knock on that door and see if Dorothy is inside.
Try it again.
I'm afraid you have the wrong house. Dorothy is not inside. Let's go find Dorothy. They failed to find you.
We were in the same town.
That's right. First question Dorothy had to answer was, who's more likely to vote for themselves in a popularity contest? You guys answered Bill. Dorothy said Bill as well. Things came horribly derailed at the second question. Dorothy was asked, who's more likely to stalk an ex-significant other? You debated for a long time. Finally said Bill. Dorothy answered Heather.
Bill interpreted the question as, if he were to break up with his wife,
then he would be more likely to stalk his wife. And I thought that was a little ridiculous. Looking back, I realized that I definitely should have stuck to my guns and said me, because it made more sense.
Third question Dorothy answered was, who's more likely to lie to a loved one? You guys answered Heather. Dorothy said Bill.
And I really felt like Dorothy would naturally lean toward me, lying to my wife. But Heather argued that it would be her.
You did not make $10,000 for the pot. Heather, you will be sequestered next. Come with me.
Okay.
Those are hard.
Try to find the town with the most number of stairs.
Yeah. Good job.
All right, Heather was asked, who's more likely to lie about their income? If she answered Bill, we'll go up there. If she answered Dorothy, we'll go up there.
I'm retired, and so it's hard to lie about.
My initial interpretation of the question was, in a social situation, who'd be more likely to try to hide their income? Maybe because you have the higher income, you may not want to reveal that.
In current life circumstances, I would say the odds of me lying are zero. I mean, every military person out there knows exactly what I make as a retired two-star. But your income is a lot more ambiguous than mine. You're doing gigs, you're doing things, you have...
See, I feel like it'd be the opposite. For a person of my age and experience, it'd be unlikely that anyone would believe me if I lied about my income anyway.
Your shot, is, what do you think?
Well, I would say you, Bill.
The second question was, who is more likely to litter?
Well, we've discussed the environment, and she knows that the environment is really important to me, so I would think that she would probably say that I wouldn't litter.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of littering, but I'm not obsessive about it.
What's one more bag of chips on the highway?
Well, if you all have discussed it, go with me.
I would say Bill.
All right. All right, this is the final question now. Who is more likely to have a loved one cheat on them? It's a charming question, as always. If you think she said Dorothy, we will go to that door. If you think it's Bill, why don't you go knock on that door?
I think it's me.
Yeah.
I think she would answer Dorothy, given that you're married and...
And then going more generally, the man is far more likely to cheat than the woman, in which case, I would agree with you.
All right, so you think Heather said that Dorothy is most likely to have a loved one cheat on them? Well, Dorothy, why don't you try the door? I'm sorry, Heather is not behind the door, so you don't get the $10,000 again. Let's go try to find Heather. Honey, I'm home. Hey, come on out. Sadly, obviously, they did not guess correctly. To the question, who's more likely to lie about their income? You guys guessed Heather would say Bill. That was wrong. The correct answer was Dorothy.
It just seems so incredibly logical to me that she would tend to fudge her value every time she tried to get a new job. And Dorothy very strongly felt like that was not the case.
Exactly what Bill said. Somebody our age has a lot to gain by embellishing a little bit on your experience.
And her argument was she doesn't make enough money to lie about it so nobody would believe her, which was crazy. I mean, I didn't understand that argument then. I still don't.
Second question Heather answered, who's more likely to litter? You guys decided Bill, and that was correct. Third question, who's more likely to have a loved one cheat on them? Pretty quickly answered Dorothy, and that was correct. You got two right, one wrong, but in this game all that matters is that you got one wrong. So didn't get the $10,000 for the pot. You have one more chance.
To me, that was a very obvious ploy on her part to give the wrong answer, so we'd lose it.
Bill, it's your turn to get sequestered, and if you'll just go down there.
Okay.
This is the last round of questions. Bill is sequestered in a house. You have three questions to try to find him. First question, Bill was asked, who would you not trust to watch your children? Do you think he said Dorothy, or do you think he said you, Heather?
He said me.
I would say you.
Yeah. Wow. Okay, why?
Probably because I'm somewhat scatterbrained, and I feel like I'm a little kid myself. I don't think he would want a big little kid watching his little kids.
All right, we'll go this way. Second question Bill was asked, who's more likely to sleep with someone to get what they want?
You just got engaged. Do you think you would?
I would think he would say me. So I think you're maybe more modest than I am. And
but do you think he would consider the engagement? Because I think then that would definitely be a no.
Yeah, I think you're right.
That's how I would think of it immediately if I were answering.
Dorothy.
That question definitely bothered me. That was the one that sort of got to me a little bit.
Time for the last question. Bill was asked, who is more likely to be alone in 10 years? If you think he said Heather, that door. If you think he said Dorothy, that door.
I think he said you just because I'm about to get married.
Yeah, and I've said numerous times that I enjoy being alone.
Okay, Dorothy, why don't you try that door, number 26. The game could be worth $100,000. You'll be racing against each other to try to get to a top secret location. The Mole's dossier awaits you there.
If Dorothy and Heather guessed all of Bill's answers correctly, he will be behind this door. If he's there, $10,000 will be added to the pot.
Man.
You guys are 3 for 3.
Jeez.
Dorothy, come on back. Bill is not there. Let's go find him. Come on out, Bill. Sadly, we were wrong. Please join the others.
I thought we were right.
So did we.
So, Bill, the first question you were asked, who do you not trust to watch your children? You guys answered Dorothy. That was incorrect.
We said Dorothy just because.
Because I feel like I'm like a little kid myself, and I don't know that you'd want to.
And my reasoning was almost exactly opposite of yours, in that you are like a kid. I think they'd love to have you there. So. That's the reason I put Heather.
Second question Bill was asked, who's more likely to sleep with someone to get what they want?
I just circled Heather because I didn't think either one of you would. I just circled whoever had not circled last time.
And the third and final question Bill was asked, who's more likely to be alone in 10 years? Heather, Dorothy.
I answered Heather, and I answered Heather because statistically,
man,
Nathan's a wonderful guy, but if you go by statistics, more than 50% of all marriages end in divorce within 5 years. So, my apologies.
Interesting.
You seem surprised, Heather.
I'm extremely surprised by that answer, actually, because
I try not to let anything offend me, but that definitely got to me. It sort of hit a personal note, just being a child of divorce and having several conversations with everybody here about how Nathan and I are so determined to be totally faithful, and it just seemed inappropriate.
You guys were 3 for 3. We weren't able to find anyone in this tiny little town. We do have another game for you, but I think we've all worked up an appetite climbing these stairs, so it's good to meet. Follow me.
It was a very difficult game, and it definitely played with the player's emotions, and it was hard not to take it personally.
Bill's the only person I suspect of sabotaging the 3 questions game.
The answers to Bill's questions were totally ridiculous, and I definitely think there is sabotage involved.
With dinner completed, the dessert menu offers instructions for the final game.
Each of you must choose one dessert, but none of you can choose the same. Meet me at the castle. Creamy castle, a treat fit for royalty. This heavenly delight is full of flavor and topped off with a dollop of stamina. Field of possibilities, garnished with greens, topped with so much whipped cream, when you find the cherry on this dessert, it is like finding a needle in a haystack. Pond parfait. A refreshing way to escape the heat. This bittersweet dessert is for those with a large appetite.
I'm just worried about the stamina thing. I'll go with...
Okay, I'll do the stamina.
You're doing the field of possibilities. I'll take pond parfait.
I hope you appreciate the view from here. You guys can see for miles, and that will help you in this, your final game. You'll be racing against each other to try to get to a top secret location. The Mole's dossier awaits you there. The first player to get to the top secret location gains entry and the opportunity to read the dossier, which could, of course, give you an edge in the final quiz. The game could be worth $100,000. Now at lunch, you are each given a dessert menu. Obviously, we're not actually picking dessert. You were picking a direction for the start of your race. Heather, you picked the pond parfait. If you'll come with me, you will be heading to that pond. At the pond, you'll find a picnic table with a GPS global positioning system on the table. It will tell you the direction to go to try to get the top secret location. Now, a GPS system works basically by arrows that go up or down. It tells you how many miles you have to go to your destination.
But those miles are as the crow flies, so you have a choice. You can follow the arrows cross-country, the most direct route, or follow the roads, which, although easier to travel, will add miles to your journey. Dorothy, you pick the field of possibilities. Behind you, you'll see a field. There are a number of haystacks in that field. On one of them is a GPS for you.
Oh, great. There's no way I'm going to find this GPS anywhere in that field. Not to mention the fact that it's looks like it's about 5 zillion miles away.
And Bill, you picked the creamy castle, I believe. So you can't see it from here, but 3.3 miles directly there, you'll find a tilted castle on a hill. At that castle, you will find a GPS directing you onward. But be careful, the terrain is treacherous at times, and you might still be racing after the sun sets. One sprained ankle or pulled muscle could end your chances of reaching the dossier in time. You can use any means necessary to get to the top secret location.
When you say any means necessary, cars, I mean, I can hotwire. Is it open?
You can't do anything illegal, but you can hitch a ride. Choose your backpack. Now keep in mind, this is a race. You're competing against each other. On your mark, get set, go. Only the first player to arrive will be admitted to the secret location. If a player arrives and the door is locked, another player has won the game and has gained access to the mole's dossier.
Hey, I thought you'd never get here. I've been waiting.
The GPS acts as a compass, showing both direction and distance to the secret location. While Heather is well on her way, Bill is still searching for his GPS.
As I was charging down through rocks and bushes and falling a few times, I charged into a patch of stinging nettles that were intertwined with rather large thorn bushes. Time to change direction.
I'm an avid hiker, and I hiked the first 1,300 miles of the Appalachian Trail last summer.
My Appalachian Trail friends are saying, "You wimp, you should already be there." Of course, they're all 21 years old.
I've had a lot of experience hiking. I've hiked in a lot of rough terrain. The mountains don't really daunt me. I mean, I'm very comfortable hiking in them. I get out of breath when I'm comfortable.
Oh. Well, that's what I've been aiming for all this time.
I arrived down the mountain, across the valley, up the next hill in a little less than an hour. I picked out a landmark that I thought was about 3 miles away, and that's where I was going.
For Dorothy, it was a long hike to the field of possibilities. But now, the hard part begins, finding her GPS.
This game is really frustrating because I feel like it's impossible to find the GPS on one of these zillions of hay bales. I hope I find this thing before the sun goes down, otherwise it's gonna be impossible.
Sunset is rapidly approaching, and more Dorothy's search for her GPS feels like looking for a needle in a haystack.
The hay field is just ridiculous. The hay is as tall as I am. The growth is really thick. I guess it's 4.63 miles.
After locating her GPS, Dorothy wastes no time leaving the hayfield and heads toward the secret location. Bill has yet to locate his GPS, and the fact that he can't speak Italian isn't helping.
Conjunto aquí, Castello, Castello, Castle, Crooked, Crooked Castle, Castle, like this, comprende?
No.
Castello de aquí, Grande House, Castello, Castello. Habla español? Sprechen Sie Deutsch?
No capisco.
Okay. Questi parlano inglese, io non lo capisco, non so che voglio. Yes, you speak English.
Yes.
I am hunting for an old castle that's crooked, that is on the hill that should be leaning over. A castle? A small castle, maybe?
A castle that's a little crooked?
Yeah, on the hill.
Never heard of a castle that's crooked.
Bello inclinado.
Trying to decide whether I should walk down to the road, which is in the opposite direction, but I might be able to find a ride. Or walk uphill towards the right direction.
I don't know where I am.
After walking for several miles, Heather finds herself right back where she started from.
The road goes east and west, and the GPS is pointing south. So basically, in front of me is where I need to go, but there's nothing but a drop-off. I thought my chances would be better than Dorothy's because of her past experiences in the games with walks and runs. I wonder how Dorothy's doing.
Tired. This uphill climb is really painful. It's really hard. It's really hard. I haven't hiked this much in a long time. Now, only 4.45 miles left.
No crooked building that you know.
Bill has found a local man who speaks some English.
Well, I'm at a loss. At a loss.
At that point, his buddy comes driving up, and they speak back and forth, and the buddy lives there.
There's a castle on the mountain.
How far, you think?
8 kilometers.
Eight. Yeah, that's still 8 kilometers more. That's too much. Is there any chance of getting a ride? Oh, I tell you, I don't understand a thing, but I enjoy riding.
Casa mia,
si. But Castello. Okay, up there. I will walk up. Thank you. Molto grazie.
They were driving about 200 miles an hour, whoosh, whoosh, and I felt like it would be just too dangerous to try to catch a ride from. Okay, people are out around here. I can find somebody to take me where I need to go.
Thank you!
So I stop a car, and I find this Italian woman, and she was very nice.
Speak English? No.
No. But she didn't speak any English at all.
Right.
We had a very hard time understanding one another.
Down.
I thought that I conveyed that I wanted to go down the mountain. So she tells me to get in. I get in the car. And I realize very quickly that she's taking me up the mountain. So I stop her and I get out. And I ask her actually if she'll take me down, and she says no. So I get out of the car and I start walking down.
It's about 3.35 miles. I'm hoping to make it there in the next hour. Assuming I don't run into more mountains to climb.
After searching for hours, Bill finally retrieves his GPS.
2.45 miles.
I'm lucky that the road is actually going in the right direction that the GPS is pointing to, so I basically follow the road all the way down the mountainside.
There's no way in hell that this is what I'm supposed to be doing. So, I'm getting really sick of this I'm really sick of you guys not talking to me. I'm sick of this game. I wanna go back to Texas. I don't care about $100,000. $536 is just fine. Now I'm increasing my mileage that I need to go. Some wild boar so I can jump out in a second. Something is not right here. I don't even know how long I've been walking for hours. And I guarantee those other two are already there. They probably found a ride. None of those cars would take me anywhere I needed to go.
The Arrow?
Uh-huh, yeah.
3 kilometers, you think? 3 kilometers, maybe?
No, more.
Brother?
.32 miles is left. I have no idea how the others managed to get to the road, if they're on the road right now. I don't know if I ended up taking a long way to the road or a short way to the road by climbing up those mountains behind the hayfield. I don't understand how it's possible that I've only gone a mile and 1.4 miles.
I didn't try very hard to get a ride, I just took off. I lined up where the castle was up on the hill and went toward it. Sort of like a bull in a china closet, I guess.
Miles left. Well, there it is. Now, what's been here and there?
Oh my God. I'm in the middle of nowhere. I don't want this to be fun. I'm asking you as from a staff crew thing. Would you stop me if something was wrong? It says I have 4.38 miles to go, so I've... But I'm in the middle of freaking nowhere, and it says I have to go south, which now is that direction. Yeah, I'm in the middle of a forest, so I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do. This is not even a real road. I'm in the middle of a freaking forest. I really don't want to do this. I really don't want to do this. Stop following me. I don't want to do this anymore. Seriously, stop. I'm lost, okay?
Are you finished?
Yes, I mean, I don't know where the hell I am.
Are you quitting the game?
Damn it.
Sir, it's okay to quit. We just need you to say that you're done, you're finished, you're quitting this game that we're playing right now.
Get up here. What?
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Wonder where the hell Heather went.
Whew.
If one of the doors is ajar, that means I'm the first one there. If they're all closed, that means somebody's beat me there. Congratulations.
Would you like to shake hands?
Sure. Wow, Bill.
I didn't think you wanted to shake hands, Anderson.
Goodness. That's right. Bill, man, what happened to your arm?
I really don't know. I did a lot of cross-country hiking. It's just superficial. But it looks nice.
It's quite impressive. Well, you beat Heather and Dorothy, you win the race, and you win the game. It is the last game of the mole. In front of you is a mole dossier. Inside could have some helpful information. And before you open it, however, I want to make you an offer. I'll add $100,000 to the pot if you pick up that dossier and hand it to me without reading the information inside. The choice is yours.
You got a cold beer?
Well, I'm not sure I have a cold beer, but I'll get one and...
And $100,000.
And $100,000 for the pot.
I didn't open the dossier for several reasons. Not the least of which is I think I know who the mole is.
All right. Congratulations.
Sorry. After doing a day that hard, after maxing out that much, after getting in there about 20% dehydrated, I'll be damned if I want to do that just to look at a piece of paper, you know? I think $100,000 is a lot better reward for that.
You're pretty confident you know who the mole is?
Yeah.
All right. I've just added $100,000 to the pot, so the pot now stands at $636,000, and that is where the pot will remain.
All right. You've made your choice.
I'll hold on to this. You're free to go.
Thank you, sir.
Wait. See ya.
Greetings.
Greetings.
Ooh, are you okay?
Oh, I just got scratched.
Ew, that's gross. That's not just a scratch, don't touch me.
No, this one's okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah. That's a hell of a hike.
It's like I haven't done this much hiking in years.
A worthy last effort. A worthy last game.
Mm-hmm.
Wonder where the hell Heather went.
With Heather in physical danger and the game over, she is finally brought to the castle.
I don't know if it was just a dog or I don't know what it was. We were deep enough into this abandoned road and forest that I was frightened, so that's when I had had enough. I knew I was lost and I was putting myself in danger because I was in the middle of a forest.
You're right. Just
totally wiped out.
Yeah, I'll bet you are.
Did you hear yourself?
Okay. Pop up.
I was attacked by a dog when I was 8 and had 30 stitches in my face, so that brought back some scary memories.
I mean, I was so far away. Well,
how far did you get?
I was way in the opposite direction. I don't even know where I was. So I just sat down, I dropped my flashlight by accident, and it was pitch black, and then all of a sudden there was like this very wild animal
And the crew guys were like, come on. And we were running away from it. It was like running by us. And I had to leave everything there because it was like, I don't know what it was, a boar, or I don't know what it was. It was growling at us and it was chasing us.
Gee whiz.
It was awful. I was freaking out. I was so scared. Oh, I was just so weird. I feel sort of in a daze right now. I mean, you know, mentally and emotionally and physically just completely beaten down. And I gave it everything I had. Like, I mean.
I know you did.
I had an emotional breakdown.
Dorothy, Heather, glad to see you made it safely. I take it you did not have a pleasant journey.
Not really.
Well, as you know, Bill was the first to arrive. He entered the secret location and in front of him found a mole's dossier. Inside it has some information that could be valuable. Before Bill opened it, he was given a choice. He could either take the dossier, read it, or I would add $100,000 to the pot if he took the dossier and handed it to me unopened. Bill, why don't you tell him about your decision?
No way in the world are we going to do the stuff we're doing tonight to read something else when we all know who we're going to vote for. Yeah. I have voted a straight ticket for the last two times, and I'm still here, and I'm comfortable. And it may be just a matter of who's fastest and who said it. So, absolutely. I mean, yeah, absolutely. I'm sorry, we need
God,
to break the record.
Screw up another game.
You didn't screw up the game.
Best news for you all is that it was the last game. Congratulations. $100,000 a day is not a bad day at all.
So we're at $636,000.
Good job. Glad you made it.
Yeah.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Welcome to the final quiz. It is now down to you, the final three. Bill, Heather, and Dorothy.
6 week period. I have never undergone such mental and after yesterday, I must say physical trials as I have in this last 6 weeks.
I'm too tired to take the quiz tonight. I don't want to take it. I don't know. It's going to be a hard quiz. I don't really know what's going to be on there, to tell you the truth.
Welcome to the final quiz. Your long journey has reached its end. 14 of you started out some 37 days ago. It is now down to you, the final three, Bill, Heather, and Dorothy. You have all played the game extremely well. You all have earned your seat here tonight at the final. One of you will be the winner of $636,000. I want to wish you all a lot of luck. Unlike previous quizzes you've taken before, tonight's quiz will be 20 questions about the mole. Some of the questions go back all the way to the start of the game. The final quiz begins now.
Question number one. As I faced you when you first met in the Castle Tarasp, which seat was the mole in, starting from my left?
My strategy for the quiz tonight is to really try to balance speed with accuracy.
Number two. What was the number on the house where the mole was sequestered during the three questions game?
I could be 100% certain and walk away from here with no money whatsoever. Skill helps, but you got to be lucky.
Number three. During high card, what was the sum total of all the cards the mole received? Face cards equal 10, ace equals 11.
You have to just trust your instinct and go with it, so that's what I'm doing.
Number four. How many times did the mole, while paired with their partners, correctly guess the other player's answers during three questions?
Every one of Bill's questions, we came up with a logical answer, and he actually put down the opposite. So therefore, he was obviously sabotaging the game.
Number five. During the repelling game, the mole answered the question at which flag?
Heather could be the mole because she fell in during the Little John, Little Jane game. She made a mistake during the repel game, and she also gambled away her winnings during the wine game.
Number six. At the pool during Think or Sink, what was the maximum number of weights the mole wore?
Bill dropped out after a mere 8 minutes and one weight added to him.
Number seven. What color backpack did the mole carry during the top secret game?
This entire time, Dorothy has been the one that's been throwing up on our hikes or our runs or walks. And she got really close to getting to the secret location last night. Didn't even seem winded, didn't seem tired.
Number 8. How does the mole deal with pressure situations? Number 9. What stage of the race was the mole selected to run during the gnome home game?
Bill dropped the gnome in the gnome home game, which lost a lot of money, so that was very suspicious.
Number 10. In what position did the mole choose their eyes in relative disguise? Number 11. In which position did the mole face Little John or Little Jane?
Dorothy has managed to wreak havoc in almost every game she's played in.
Number 12. What bad habits does the mole have that we should know about? Number 13. Does the mole wear prescription glasses? Number 14. Who did the mole choose to be their eyes in relative incognito?
There's a huge smokescreen here with Heather. How in the devil did Nathan know he knew he was going to get his ring and bring it here? He had to order that ring a long time ahead.
Number 15. In which position was the mole given the opportunity to jump during the relative bungee game?
I am not going to jump.
Number 16. Who was the mole's hero or idol as a child? Number 17. How many times did the other two players correctly guess the mole's answers in the three questions game?
As I go back over the game, Heather has had a pattern of things I find suspicious.
Number 18. Who is the mole's favorite artist? Number 19. How many different rides did the mole get from locals during the top secret game? And number 20. Who is the mole?